In the past history, first we should always rule out if the patient has tuberculosis, diabetes, hypertension or a thyroid disorder. It has a very important significance as these conditions are very common and they should always be ruled out beforehand because they might interfere with the treatment that you are giving to the patient. Also, these have to be managed. Like if the patient has to be started on steroids, in that case if the patient has tuberculosis or diabetes, these conditions will get aggravated. Similarly, if the patient is being decided to get operated, if the patient has hypertension, there are high chances that the patient can go into massive bleed. Or if the patient has hyperthyroidism, there are chances that the patient might go into thyroid storm. So first of all, in the past history, you should always rule out these conditions. The next thing is, what we do in past history is just the extension of the HOPI. You can place these points either in the HOPI or the past history, depending on what is the case. Like if the case is suspected to be of hernia, you can ask if the patient has any previous history of abdominal surgery and you can place it in past history. Similarly, for complication, like if the patient is suspected to be of COPD, you can ask if there were any previous such episodes, because if there are previous such episodes present, then the treatment plan changes accordingly as per the ABCD guidelines. Personal history, which includes diet, sleep cycle, bowel and bladder habits, substance abuse and allergy to medication. The first one is diet, in which we ask the patient if the patient takes a vegetarian diet or takes a mixed diet. The significance of this is, like if the patient is continuously on vegetarian diet and we suspect it to be a case of anemia, in that case we should highly suspect that the patient might have B12 deficiency, as we get B12 mainly from the animal meat. Similarly, in case of malignancies, the different diets can be the risk factors for different malignancies, so you can take a detailed history if you suspect such in the HOPI. The second is the sleep cycle. You should ask the patient if the patient is sleeping well or if from the past few days or past few months the patient's sleep cycle is altered. Like in case of hyper or hypothyroidism, the sleep cycle might be altered. One also very important thing which I found is, like if you are suspecting it to be a case of CVS, in that case if you ask the patient that if the breathlessness increases on lying down, the patient usually says no. But when you ask if the patient's sleep cycle is altered, then the patient tells that yes, I cannot sleep at night because I feel breathlessness. So in orthopnea can also be detected if you take a history of sleep cycle. Similarly, third is the bowel and bladder habits, which you should ask. Like these can be some problematic conditions for the patient, which should also be treated, and they also might point towards a cause. And if they are significant, then they should be mentioned in the HOPI itself. Like if you are suspecting it to be a case of intestinal obstruction, then history of constipation should be mentioned in the HOPI only and not in the personal history. Then next is the substance abuse, which is a very important part of history taking. Especially the history of alcohol and smoking should be very detailed. Like for alcohol, you should mention about how much gram per day the patient is taking. The significance is, like if the patient takes about 80 gram of alcohol per day for 10 to 20 years, then the patient is at high risk of fatty liver. Whereas if the patient takes more than 160 gram per day for 10 to 20 years, the patient has a high risk of cirrhosis. This I am talking about the male. So you should know about the exact amount of alcohol the patient is taking per day. How you calculate is, you should know about the concentration in different type of alcohol, like what is the concentration in beer, whiskey, and then you multiply it with amount taken per day, for which you should know what is the amount in one peg, one quarter, one half or a bottle. Similarly, smoking histories should be also very detailed. Like one is what patient takes, like if the patient takes a BD or cigarette, as the BD is more dangerous, then amount per day, and then you calculate the pack years. It also has a significance, like if the patient takes more than 15 pack years per day, then it increases the risk of COPD, whereas if the pack years are more than 30, it has a high risk for lung cancer. And the fifth one is allergy to medication, which should also be known. Like if you are starting the patient on any treatment, you should know that if the patient has had any reaction to that medicine before, so that you can be cautious.